All the theories related to metazoan origin are of only two kinds and could only be of two kinds. First possibly is that metazoan status was achieved by the coming together of two or more cells forming a colony, whether by incomplete separation of daughter cells after mitosis or by independent aggregation of formally separate cells in a symbiotic fashion. The second major possibility is that a single cell became multinucleate without divisions of the cytoplasm, forming a plasmodium organism, and that cell boundaries were established later to give a multicellular animals with many primitively sensitive tissues. Colonial Blastia or Gastria series, works of Haeckel, 1874-1875, a view of metazoan origins involving blastula-like and gastula-like stages succeeding a phase of aggregation of protistan flagellates has long been influential. Dependent on recapitulation theories suggesting that the blastula of modern embryo recapitulates their ancestry as a blastia organisms. The basic metazoan was thus a pelagic, radially symmetrical aggregation of flagellate cells as currently represented by forms like volvox. A gastria stage which the gastula of modern embryos recapitulates would arise from the blastia by a separation of locomotory and digestive regions, the latter being posterior and gradually tucking in to form an interior endoderm. These gastria form a single, simple, two-layered sac-like organism, readily give rise to the similarly constructed aseptic cnidarians, from which other metazoans subsequently evolved. Haeckel's theory has the great merits of simplicity and elegance and presents a strong appeal in the orderliness of its explanations. Some demerits, objections are also there. Though there are many colonial flagellate protists, all the existing blastula-like types are unequivocally plants and all have incomplete separation of constituent cells with fine cytoplasmic ridges connecting the colony. Now, Archicillomate Theories of Metazoan Origin. The simple blastula form must invaginate to form a diploblastic gastria organism, and in all phyla except sponges, there must be a degree of internal elaboration of gastric surfaces. This would occur in a pelagic animal and proposed four original gastric pouches in cyclomerism theory by Remen, as shown in the figure. Jagersten and subsequently Stewing suggested that the ancestral form had become benthic before gastrulation occurred, and giving a particularly bilateral gastria as shown in the figure lower low, or a rather similar benthogastria respectively, each having three pairs of gastric pouches. Trocha theory, one variant of gastria theories that does avoid some of the problem areas, has recently been advanced by Nielsen and Noray Wang, 1985. They suggest that a common monociliate gastria stalk gave rise directly to cnidaria and also via a trochea stage with an equatorial ring of multiciliate cells to the remaining bilateral phyla. This occurred through trochophore larvae on the spiralian side and through a tornea larva on the deuterosome side. The latter forms losing its multiciliation again. Colonial Blastia and Planula theories, it is presumed that the primitive metazoans first originated from spherical hollow colonial flagellate. The evidence in support of this particular statement, like sperm cells, are flagellated in all metazoans. And in lower metazoans, such as sponges, in many cnidarians, the monociliated cells occur within the body. The cells of the colony bear collar-like structure around a single flagellum and possess anterior-posterior axis and would swim by placing the anterior pole forward. The cells were differentiated into somatic, that means non-reproductive, and reproductive cells. Haeckel proposed this hypothetical ancestral stage, the Blastia, as a first stage in metazoan origins. Blastia may be compared with the existing blastula stage of the multicellular animals and resemble the present-day Volvox colony. The next evolutionary stage is a solid, non-evaginated structure of the archimetazoan, which is called parenchymula or planalia, that means also called as planula. The planula ancestor is represented as a small, ovoid, pelagic animals with radial symmetry, containing solid mass of cells and the internal cell mass to be considered as the migratory cells of the blastula stage. A thorough review of these theories and their strength is given by Salvini Palwan, 1978, and a summary of likely stages in metazoan evolution based on his views and to a lesser extent presented in this particular animation you are watching right now. Several points can be made in support of this theory. It embraces both pelagic and benthic forms and radial and bilateral forms in a single theory, permitting all the metazoa to be monophyletic from flagellate ancestors. It provides a good starting point for most of the lower phyla, as planunoid larvae occur not only in the many cnidarians but also in a few sponges and at least one actinophore. It nearly provides a plausible status for the particular placozoans and rather solid forms of Blastia forming incipient planulae, according to Ivan of 1973. In this particular animation, it's actually about the scheme of invertebrate origins in which planula is central to all further developments beyond the first acquisition of multicellularity. And colonial quanoflagellate cells give rise to here Blastia, separate gamete cells develop, dark circle there, and ingression gradually produces an internal layer, and thus a true planula, sponges, placozoans, cnidarians, ctenophores. So in this animation, all supports related to this particular theory is clearly visible enough. Syncytial, ciliate or acyloid theories. The origin of metazoans probably took place through the growth, nuclear division and cellularization of a single protozoans. Depending on this idea, Haji, 1953-1963, proposed the syncytial ciliate theory. His version, supported by several scientists like Steinbeck, Hansen, Haji proposed that the first metazoan evolved from a primitive multinucleated protozoans of a ciliate type. They mentioned a process of cell boundary formation in a multinucleate plasmodial protozoans of a ciliate type, perhaps one like paramecium, or possibly of an aberrant form such as opalina. And it's an odd protozoan, usually given either status rather. A bilateral ancestor of this kind could very directly give rise to the acyl turbellarians, as shown in the figure, the animation, the lower portion representing acyl flatworms, and the upper one is representing paramecium-like proteids, so which lack any gut lumen. That means the turbellarians devoid of any kind of gut lumens, In particular, Haji believed the midgut tissue in Acela to be primitively syncytial in nature and standing as a testimony to a genuine link with Plasmodium protists. Acyl would then be ancestral to all other metazoans except possibly sponges, which could have a separate origin from flagellates.